He has been frozen for 4,000 years, unexpectedly. Now he is alive. Because he can't fit into the present knife, so he's locked up in a lab. This is the North Pole. This scientific expedition team is testing on ice. They discover a huge iceberg inside. It seems like there is something inside. Everyone guesses it is a mammoth with a long nose. Then the iceberg is transported to the research center. They are expecting there will be something special. He cuts the iceberg. It's appearing. They are all surprised. It's an ancient man. According to scientist Kud, this is a primitive man from 480,000 years ago. Maybe he is a hunter. Then, they dare not to keep cutting anymore. They move him to a hotter room to melt the ice. It's melting. He looks like 30. His whole body is covered with animal skin. They carefully cut it. Now, they detect he is still alive. His brain and other organs are extremely healthy because before he was frozen, he had eaten a special fruit. It's like a preservative. Wood speculates, this man has been suddenly frozen. It proves that he can be alive now. They perform a surgery. They change his blood and inject adrenaline and use a pacemaker. Immediately, he is alive. But he is so scared. Wood immediately takes off his protective clothing and he looks at them who are familiar to him. Now he's better. They inject him with sedatives to put him in a coma. This man was frozen for 40,000 years. Thanks for those scientists. He is alive now. They start talking about him. Someone suggests researching antifreeze technology to freeze untreated patients. When conditions permit, we will thaw and continue treatment. But Wood suggests observing his life activity, and they will study human evolution. So he is locked in an artificial forest. There are mountain, waterfall, birds. It's like a real wildlife. He wakes up. Without doubt, they want to know if he can hunt. They let in a wild boar, then he kills it. Those scientists discover he knows how to smash rocks to make fire. Looking at him, they are very excited. He is catching fish. Suddenly he sees a water pipe. Following the pine, he finds out a door. But he is very frightened. He screams. Then he's not happy anymore. He always feels uncomfortable. Wood decides to meet him. He is scared. Then he is calm now. He touches Wood. He knows Wood is a man like him. They start talking. Wood knows his name is Chelu, but he doesn't understand other words. After many days of talking, Wood feels close to Chelu. He is very kind. But other scientists, they don't see Chelu as a human. They collect a large amount of body tissue from him. For study, Chelu sees his scars. He realizes he is just a test subject. He begs Wood to kill him. After 40,000 years frozen, this is the first time he has seen a woman. Then he has a silly behavior. Wood warns him. She is mine. Chelu stops. But Chelu misses his wife. He draws a person. His wife's name is Ipapa, and his son is Tiramisu. Chelu introduces about his family. He wants to know where they are. It's so cool. Chelu, he doesn't know that he is the loneliest person in this world. There is a helicopter. Chelu is terribly scared. He climbs on the highest mountain and shouts Beata. A person from Eskimo tells Wood. Beata means god bird. In ancient times, when a person is in a trouble, he thinks it is divine punishment. Only by making sacrifices to the gods, he will be able to avoid it. Chelu lived in that ancient times, and animals gradually died and humans had no food. To save his family, Chelu has decided to find Godbird and dedicated his life to the gods. When he sees the helicopter, Chelu thinks that he has found out the Godbird, and Chelu has stayed up for 3 days. He always mutters a word. It looks like he is doing some kind of ritual. When Wood comes, Wood sees Chelu is so weak. It looks like he wants to say something. Chelu begs Wood to help him find out Godbird. It's Chalu's hope. It's his dream in 40,000 years. Wood has no choice. Immediately, he leads Chelu out of the research center and gives him freedom to help him complete his desire. Seeing snow, Chelu is so happy. Wood can't catch up with Chelu anymore. Even after hearing the terrifying sound of an iceberg breaking, Chelu doesn't look back. He keeps going, hopefully to fulfill his mission. Finally, Chelu sees his godbird. He jumps and grabs it. It pulls him into the sky. This man wants help, Chelu. But Chelu smiles and lets it go. He is singing an Eskimo song. He just wants to dedicate himself to the godbird and to his beliefs. Then his wife and his son will be saved. His tribe is also saved. He has waited for it for 40,000 years. The end. I want to ask you a question. Do you know who plays this primitive man?